I've not been back there in years, but it was the last place left to look. Those lost wishes weren't the treasure I was after. It was not exactly as I remembered it, but it wasn't all that different either. Two odd contraptions guarding the lost treasure. I would have to turn one and see what happened. Even though the bed was very comfortable, this was no time to hide under the covers.
Wait. Hold on. I don't remember this part of the story. Beds hanging from stalactites?
We'll get there, Gwendolyn. Don't worry. No detail in this story will be overlooked. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. As I treaded through the river of rumbling troubles, I feared I knew the source of that deafening wind. Nestled beneath a slumbering pile of teeth and claws was...
Fabled Mirror!
Oh, so you remember this part of the story.
Well, dragons are my favorite.
You want to tell this part?
Yes. King Edward sent me, the greatest knight in all of Daventry, on a quest to return his stolen mirror. A gigantic, hulking beast of a dragon was the last thing in my way to...
My way to add a shinier hat to my collection. I tried to turn that crazy contraption, but it was missing a handle. Someone tampered with it, creating some silly conundrum. As I was saying, this was no time to take a nap. Volumes of old books with foreboding titles clutter the shelves of that strange bedroom. How to Tame a Dragon, Breaking the Spirit of Hideous Beasts, Amateur Spells to Impress Your Friends With. No books about covering missing handles.
So, the missing handle was booby-trapped? What did you do?
Well, I used my cleverness to outsmart the trap. Then I used my cleverness to hide. Luckily, that half-blinded beast never notices me in bed.
A dragon's eye must be really hard to pierce with an arrow. At archery lessons, I can barely hit a hay bale.
It is indeed a feat only for skilled archers. I tried to turn that crazy contraption, but it was missing a handle. Someone tampered with it, created some silly conundrum.
What did you use to fix the broken switch?
Dragon's chains were coiled around a gigantic switch mounted to the cave wall. After he briefly basked in the sun, the narcoleptic dragon went back to snoring.
I probably sleep all day too, if Amira was my only friend.
whoever designed this trap thought they were pretty clever, but I would probably find a way to hit that unreachable switch. The mirror called out to me. A ridiculous feeding contraption cobbled together to keep the beast and probably its owner alive.